Use the graph below to answer the following question about f of x. E. How would you describe the concavity of f of x over the interval from 0 to 5 for x and over the interval from 5 to 8 for x? Well, before we can answer this question, we have to understand concavities. So let's take a look at the chart that we have here. Notice, first of all, we've got the term increasing. Increasing means that the graph is rising from left to right. In talking about slope, we can say that the slope is positive. So I'll go ahead and indicate here that for functions that are increasing, the slope is positive. And on the other hand, if we have a function that is decreasing, then we notice that the graph falls from left to right. In terms of slope, the slope is negative. Now for a concavity, concavity has something to do with the curvature of the graph. Notice for the linear functions that there is no curvature. It's just a straight line. The slope is not only positive here, but it's also constant. For the decreasing line, the slope is negative, but the slope is also constant. So for linear functions, we have the slope is constant. And when the slope is constant, there isn't any curvature. The graph's not curving up or curving down. It's just a straight line. If we look at concave up, we notice that the graph is curving in an upward direction. The graph is curving in an upward direction. The reason for that is that the slope is getting larger. Over here to the left, the slope is relatively close to zero. And then the slope gets more and more positive. So as we increase from zero to positive values, we see that the slope is increasing. Here, the graph is decreasing. The slope is clearly negative over here to the left. But then as we move to the right, the slope gets relatively close to zero. And as we move from negative numbers to zero, those numbers are increasing. So when a graph is concave up, we think of the slope increasing. The slope is increasing. And then for concave down, we notice that the function is curving in a downward direction. The reason for that is that the slope is decreasing. Here we have positive slope on the left. And then as we move to the right, the slope is getting less and less. It's getting relatively close to zero. So the slope is decreasing. On the other hand, here the slope is relatively close to zero, but then gets more and more negative. And as we go from zero into the negative values, the numbers are decreasing in size. And so we say that the slope is decreasing. All right, so let's go back to our question. How would you describe the concavity of f of x over the interval from 0 to 5 for x? So what we want to do is to locate the interval from 0 to 5 for x. So we look at the x-axis and we start at 0. And we go to 5. Now notice that we have 12 here and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tick marks. 12 divided by 6 is 2. So each tick mark is 2 units. So 0, 2, 4, and then here's 5. And so we're looking on the interval from 0 to 5. And we want to write down what we observe about the concavity. Okay, well, we notice that first of all, the function's increasing, and then it levels off, and then it's decreasing. But the most important thing in regards to concavity is that the curve is curving in a downward direction. We have positive slope, zero slope, and then negative slope. The slope is decreasing, and therefore the function is concave down on this interval. So on the interval from 0 to 5, we notice that the graph is concave down. Okay, over the interval from 5 to 8, we We start at 5 and we end at 8. And we want to look at that interval. So we look at the function. We notice that it's decreasing, but it's curving in an upward direction. The slope is negative, and then the slope is getting closer to 0. The slope is increasing. Looks kind of similar to the picture that we have here, where the function is decreasing but concave up. So over the interval from 5 to 8, we say that the function is concave up.